A Shawarminator Nader Aider.
Hey, Shawarminator Aiders.
Hello, Shawarminator Aiders.
I don't
hate Shawarminator Aiders.
So I'm thinking of making some falafels. Cooked up a killer batch just now. It's quite a mission to make one. Oh, what if I won? I mean, a whole batch. I think the falafels would be a pretty good addition. But I'm going to stick to the shawarmas for now. Really just focus on that. Make sure that we've got a very good business. And the only reason we started to think about adding falafels is while I was trying to hand out some free samples of shawarmas recently, some people were vegetarians. And I just, you know, we need to target them as well. And by target, you know, I don't mean like, ooh, we need to take over the world and make as much money as possible, but because the food is so good, and you don't really get good falafels here in South Africa, again, because it's not authentic, I think they use a lot of that powdered shit. That's just an update. See you later, alligators. Hey, so things are coming together nicely. Right, so this thing just switched off on its own. I'm using a Cam 1, by the way. I'm no longer using my iPhone, I'm using a nice... I guess it's a GoPro competitor, you can call it. Got the fridge, freaking awesome. Don't mind the way that the trailer looks on the inside at the moment. I've just been unpacking and putting stuff here recently. So, okay, I'm not usually this bad, but my wife might disagree. Look, we got ourselves a bit of an inverter here to try and be not as bad to the environment. There's the beautiful machine. One that does everything. That styrofoam box is what I put my bread in to keep it nice and warm and not to allow any moisture to come in. And I got my chef gear, which I'm probably gonna try on tonight for the missus. But you guys, I'm not gonna film that because then it might be considered inappropriate for the younger audiences anyway. Who knows, my kids might see it and say, oh my god, mom, dad, this is gross. The stuff, this is my chef gear. It doesn't have a sign on it yet. I need to still find out where I can get that done. Get our emblem on there on the front and the back. Yeah, that's about it for now. Cheerio, yo. Okay, so we're still in St. Francis Bay. Doing another market day. Very early. I was here at about 5:30, just to get my trailer kind of ready, mostly to avoid, you know, this. There's a lot of people coming. They all want to be here early to ensure that everyone's got a place. You can see we put on our temporary decals. This isn't the final product, but eventually the whole thing's going to be done. I'd like to share the whole artwork with you, but it's nicer if it's a surprise, you know. Right, so time to set up. Right, let's transform into the Shawarminator. Hey, I am the Shawarminator.
And that's a food quality issue. And it's just not fair the way things are set up that way. But if you're poor, you have a hard time getting food that doesn't make you inflamed, it doesn't break your insulin, it doesn't contain things that make you weak.
It's going down.
It's tragic.
It's going good. The meat wasn't even ready yet, but there were some people who didn't care. They wanted it red. They could smell it, and they said it's amazing. 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 And right now, pumping. Just waiting for lunchtime. I've been worried because it's just me.
Not just dating success, and, but the way people address you and the way you.
And I'm not pre-preparing them this time simply because I just don't want it to get soggy and yucky. And I just want to make sure the meat's still hot. And anyway, the truth is the meat isn't ready yet. There's still a lot of red meat. Well, what am I doing? I'm sitting here. I'm listening to the Joe Rogan Experience. I freaking love that podcast. There is so much you can learn from it. It is insanely informative. And if you don't mind a lot of cussing and then stuff. You know, he's a stand-up comedian and a UFC commentator, and he's a mixed martial artist himself, and he's the guy from the X, what is it, Fear Factor, and he's just done so much in his life as Joe Rogan, dude. Love it. Anyway, you should check it out and enjoy it. Hey, Shawarminator Aiders. Wanted to give a nice quick update, so we had a good day today. Sold out, and we learned a few things. One is that Regardless of how much meat you think you've got on that shawarma, when you buy it raw, if it weighs 8 kilos, it's not always going to be 8 kilos. You know, a lot of meat, obviously a lot of fat and grease, and the liquid just kind of burns off of it and melts away because of the heat, obviously. And yeah, I just thought I'd share that, let you guys know. And also had some really nice feedback. For example, my favorite feedback today was that my prices are a bit low, and I thought that's a very interesting observation by some folks, and I was very happy with that. And the other thing, of course, is the food was great. I only kept getting awesome reviews on the food, which is like, wow, that's fantastic. And then just now I wanted to share, and I was driving here, I'm driving around Cape St. Francis Bay heading to my next destination. I mean, like from out of the house, not like another country or anything. And yeah, and I just realized, you know, this is such a beautiful town. It's nice to see it nice and full, a lot of people here. But it's going to be very sad to leave. We had a beautiful house here, and, you know, families here as well. However, we completely know that, at least I know for sure, there's no way Shawarminator would succeed here. Not in the piece of shit car I'm driving right now, which I love. I love my car. It's a Jeep Grand Cherokee Model 2000, gold color and all of that. But sadly, it's struggles with the towing, even though the trailer isn't exactly that heavy. And I've got my eye on a couple of cars. Most notably either the Isuzu or the Ford Ranger. So anyway, just wanted to share that. I think what I'll do before we sign out and leave St. Francis Bay, I'll probably put a nice collage of pictures of this town. And I absolutely urge everyone and anyone, if they can, in South Africa, to visit even for December or April or wherever, whenever there's a proper holiday. You will not regret it. It's such an absolutely stunning place. All right. This is me signing out, wishing you all a good evening, and remember, be nice to your mom and your dad, call them, say hi, tell them you love them, tell your kids you love them, and just be good. Just remember, everyone in life is in life together, so just be good. Be good to each other. Alright, cheers, peace, bye. Shawarminator Aiders. Here again, I'm back at my office. A little bit of a different location today. We're back on Main Beach. Well, the good news is that the beach has finally gotten a bit clear. What was happening is there was so much seaweed under the water, and this water was all kind of maroon or brown or gray and miserable. So, yeah, it's freaking gorgeous here. Absolutely nice. Anyway, let's hope we sell out. In fact, I'm sure we will. And sadly, because it was raining this morning, I didn't actually pack enough meat. In fact, the meat is already cooked. It's already done. I've already cleaned up. Sitting up there, heating up. Or staying warm, I should say. And yeah, it's gonna be nice. It's gonna be nice. Right. And on that note, remember to be nice to each other, because that's what we are. We are nice to each other. And Shawarminator is a nice company, and nice people, and a nice man. Okay. Peace.